everybody, and welcome back to this tutorial. And right now, let us see how we can download Python for Windows. Now, we have to actually visit a certain link, so open up your Google Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, or whatever search engine you are using, and we're going to navigate to the python.org/downloads. So go up right up here, http, python.org/downloads, and then add another slash at the end of this link. Press here enter. Now once again, this will lead us to a page where we can download different versions of Python. It will show us right here, as we can see, that the latest version of Python currently is Python 3.7.3. As I said before, if you have a newer version, feel free to download that one, as long as it is a Python 3 version and not Python 2. We can see the release dates right here and different versions. This is ours that we are going to download, released on the March 25th, 2019. Now, you might be asking whether you are going to download a 32-bit or 64-bit version, but we're going to get into that just in a second. Once you actually check all of these things out, and you can read these licenses sources if you want to, nothing really important right here. And right here, right upper there, you can read looking for Python with a different OS. We want to click Python for Windows. And right here, we're going to have a different versions for Python 3.7.3. Now note this statement right here that says Python 3.7.3 cannot be used on Windows XP or earlier. So if you are using Windows XP, which I highly doubt, it is 2019, nobody is using XP anymore. But if you are, you're going to have to upgrade or download a different version of Python, since this one won't work on Windows XP. Now, you can see also these different things right here, such as stable releases and pre-releases. Now, pre-releases are basically, as you can see, Python 3.8.0, which is basically a release that hasn't really been released yet as a stable release, so it is something still in progress of working. So what we want to do is we want to download a stable release, because we want our Python to work perfectly. And you can have right here different versions that you want to download, such as the x86 and x86-64. Now, the x86 is 32-bit and the 64 is the 64-bit. Now, in order to check whether your PC is 32-bit and or 64-bit, so you can know which one you can download, you can go right here. So just open up your search bar in the actual Windows 10. You can just type here start, we want to type control panel, so control panel, open your control panel right here. It will lead you to your settings. You want to go and navigate to the system and security settings, and right here you want to find, let me just see where it is. Okay, so system settings, right here. And right here, you can just under the system type, check out whether your operating system is, or whether your processor is 32 or 64-bit. And you can see my is currently 64-bit, so I will be downloading the 64-bit version. So let us close this, and the 64-bit version would be this one, so Windows x86-64 executable installer. Click on it. It will start downloading. As we can see, it is 25 megabytes long, or big, should I say. And right here, we have that version right here. Since I already did download it, you can see it is the same name. So all you want to do is run your executable installer program. You can see right here, it opens a window, install Python 3. We want to just click on install now. It will ask for the administrator password, which I don't have, so I will just click here yes. And it will start installing or setting up our Python 3 for us. And basically all you want to do is follow the actual process of installation. And if you want to later on, you can add the Python 3 to the path so you can run it from anywhere you like. Now this shouldn't take too long to install. Basically it is right now installing and downloading all the additional libraries that it needs in order to be able to run. And what we are going to do afterwards in the next video is I will show you a few commands that you can run in order to install Python 3 for the Ubuntu. Now, those of you who are using Ubuntu probably already know that the any Linux type of system basically already comes with Python and Python 3, but we want to install some different usable things, or useful things, should I say, such as pip for Python, installing different modules, libraries, idle, and basically the Python 3 interpreter. So, I will just leave this to finish, and I will get back to you as soon as this has finished. Okay, so right here we are getting towards the end of the actual setup. It shouldn't take more than a few seconds more to finish this. It took rather a while, I mean, not a while, it took around 2 to 3 minutes to finish this, which is not that long, but I actually thought it would finish a little bit faster. But here we can see everything has finished, and I hope that soon we will get prompted the finish button, which we can click and then run the Python 3. So you can see the last thing it installed is the Python 3 pip bootstrap 64-bit. Let me just move this right here. This installation file, right after you actually finish installing Python 3, you can just delete. There is no need to keep it right here, but if you want to, you can just leave it right there. So right here we can have setup was successful, special thanks to and then Mark Hammond. Okay, so nothing really important right here. Disable path length limit, change your machine configuration to allow programs including Python to bypass the 260 characters max path limitation. Now this is not really anything important to us, but if you want to, you can just click it. What this means is basically the path is the actual environment in Windows where you can actually run the program from any directory you want. So for example, if you want to run Audacity right here, this program on my desktop, from any other directory that isn't a desktop directory, you can add it. You can add the executable of this program to the actual path, and it will be able to run it from anywhere. But more about that later on. Right now, just click here, close, and we have Python 3 installed. Now, in order to check that out, you can just type here idle, and you can see right here I have a bunch of different versions of Python 3. Right here, we are interested in Python 3.7, 64-bit, and if you open the idle, it will open up the Python 3 interpreter, which we are going to talk about more later on. As we can see, the version is 3.7.3, which is the version that we downloaded. So more about that later on. What I'm going to show in the next video is for the Ubuntu and the macOS users, how to download Python and how to run it. And for those of you who are running this on Windows, you can just skip the next tutorial and get straight into the idle demonstration. So hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye!